Peter Forsberg was as tough as it got when it came to play the game.
He was not only a fantastically skilled player, but he was tough as can be, probably to the detriment of his career because he was often injured because of the way he played. But he would always put himself in harm's way if he could make a play that would help his team.
Not many players in the game of hockey could combine the toughness, the physicality, and the pure skill, and Peter Forsberg certainly had all three.
Peter Forsberg as the centerpiece for the Quebec Nordiques in the deal that saw Eric Lindros sent to Philadelphia resoundingly met the lofty expectations surrounding his rookie season in 1995, tallying 50 points in just 47 games to win the Calder Trophy.
Forsberg was terrific and a great player to watch, and I'm sure if you played with him, you really appreciated his ability.
The following season, with the franchise relocated and renamed the Colorado Avalanche, Forsberg compiled 116 points and then, in the postseason, helped power the team to its first ever Stanley Cup.
He was incredible. He was the one guy that every team had to find a way to stop Peter Forsberg, and it freed up ice for everybody else. One guy couldn't contain him, so somebody else would have to come and always leave somebody open, and he had the vision that he could make any play all over the ice.
The lore for so many generations was that European hockey players aren't tough. Peter Forsberg was a rock.
In the 2001 playoffs, as testament to his legendary toughness, Forsberg unknowingly played through a ruptured spleen during the seventh game of the second round. Rallying around the loss of their star center, the Avalanche went on to win the Stanley Cup. Forsberg, while recovering from the injury, didn't play a single minute in the 2001-2002 regular season, but returned to lead all playoff performers in scoring as the Avalanche reached the Western Conference Final.
Peter Forsberg worked so hard at rehab and now makes his triumphant return.
The Swedes they're tough, tough, tough players. They show it in a very different way, and he was a leader in that regard. In fact, I think he enjoyed the game in the trenches and playing the game in the corners and winning battles as much as he did scoring goals.
The 2002-2003 season was perhaps the finest of Forsberg's career, as the Swede led the NHL in assists and points and captured the Hart Trophy as league MVP.
When Peter was playing his best game, to me, he was unstoppable.
He didn't play an easy game. He played a full ice game, physical, and that had a lot to do with him maybe not playing as long as he possibly could have.
You know, sometimes, like Peter, you don't have to play that physical. He says, he says, I like it.
Injuries continued to take a serious toll on Forsberg's career that included stops in Philadelphia and Nashville. But his productivity, when on the ice, never suffered. Forsberg recorded 249 goals, 636 assists, and 885 points in just 708 games. On a per-game basis, he ranks fourth in assists and eighth in points all time. While the raw numbers are most certainly impressive, what Peter Forsberg will most be remembered for is the way he played and the way he inspired.
Talk about a fierce competitor. You talk about a guy that I think still has a little grudge on his shoulder to this day. But that's what made him him, and I have the utmost respect for him.
Not for injury, Peter Forsberg truly would have put up magnificent numbers. And even without those magnificent numbers, he's in the Hockey Hall of Fame. That speaks volumes of what type of player he was.